What
Alan
said, going to a place.
Yeah, going to
a place.
Let's see what's going on here.
What's
showing some evidence of a certain.
So,
even
your sacrifice.
No.
So what?
But actually, works against your. No, it comes against your.
You may have distorted Sahih Bukhari.
But it goes against your point. Because if this is found in your source.
Because always Muslim they bring a distorted Sahih Bukhari.
If this is found in your source.
Thank you very much.
We know your text.
If this is found in your source.
We know your lie all the time.
When it will be the day of resurrection, Allah will deliver.
Muslims are not reliable at all.
Hello. Okay, so if this is found in your source,
let's check the evidence. You're the calm one in this.
Yeah,
I just want to throw that madness out there.
Because he's an old man, I don't want to show him.
Can you kindly pull this gentleman away?
No, I'm not his mother.
My point is, if your sources say this, you can't honestly have a problem with people atoning for sins according to the Bible, because according to this, your God is saying he replaces Jews and Christians for the sins of Muslims.
No, it's not. I looked it up.
It's Sahih. It's Sahih. Yeah. It's literally Sahih.
It is Sahih.
If you can't score, yeah.
I can hear from him.
Oh, is it? Yes, Sahih Muslim. It's literally Sahih Muslim.
You will not hear me.
So, bro, here's the thing. The idea of atoning sacrifice.
The idea of atoning sacrifices, right?
No. They're appealing to your God. So the problem is, you're going to have to now explain why your God is allowing Jews.
No, I will. Let's come back to earth, please. For a minute. Yeah, just for a minute.
But my point is, if your problem is with the Christian God using Jesus Christ to atone for the sins of man, then you would have a problem in your hadith, because this is saying Jews Jews and Christians are going to appeal for the.
Yeah, yeah.
Now he wants to divert because he cannot judge.
You can claim that, but you don't know what's in my heart. I will focus.
What I want you to do now.
Your heart is a deceiver.
What I want him to do now is I want you to say that. I want you to say that Allah was wrong for saying this. I want you to say that.
You see, let's.
No, I want. Before we talk about the Bible, I want to say Allah was wrong for saying that Jews and Christians have got to pay for the sins of Muslims.
Can we agree to some decorum a little bit? Is it possible?
I'm being as decorum as I can. I'm just saying, if we're going to be consistent, understandable.
No, no.
But if we're going to be consistent, and if you're attacking Christian worldview for atoning sins,
I'm not attacking anything.
Then you've got a problem here.
No, I'm clarifying. Can we please hold some respect? You say you don't want to attack anybody's belief. I don't want to attack your belief. We're just clarifying things. It's not an attack. It's not like this gentleman.
What do you mean?
That's what I'm doing right now.
These are your texts, please.
No.
These are your texts. Okay. If they are going against you, that's your problem.
Exactly. Okay.
That's your problem,
exactly.
Not his problem.
Exactly.
Because these are your texts, your hadith, your scholar, your writer.
When you said Allah.
What I'm saying is Allah is claiming that Jews and Christians will burn in hell for the actions of Muslims sins, basically.
I looked it up, it's not the hadith Sahih.
It is Sahih hadith, it's written
anyway,
there. It's literally Sahih hadith. So what you have to say,
what I want him to do is, if he is consistent, he has to say that this
God is a liar, a demon from Satan, if he's going to be a consistent attack the atonement in the Christian Bible.
No.
If you're going to be consistent.
Is this Christian practice to attack anybody's belief this way?
I'm not attacking your belief. I'm attacking your contradiction.
When you say.
If you can bring mutawat hadith that says that this is a lie, then please do it.
Okay.
It's got to be mutawat.
That's fair, uncle.
No. Why do you have to shout? We have one guy shouting already.
I want to make sure that you're engaging in the conversation. You have to respect your hadith, uncle.
Let's stay on the point, because I want you to be consistent. So show me mutawat hadith that says that this is wrong.
Okay, I will. But while I'm looking for that, my brother, I'll show you. Give me the hadith number, my brother.
Okay, so Sahih Muslim 2767. You can see it there.
No, in Arabic. I want to see it in Arabic.
Oh, Arabic.
Yeah.
Wait. It should be there.
Hold it there. Okay. I got it. Does this? Can you keep the Arabic up just for a minute? I want to type.
Yeah, no.
Because I have something here. I'm sorry to trouble you, my brother. Are you cold or are you naturally shaking, my brother?
It's all good. It's a natural thing.
Lower the suitcase, man.
Yeah, I should probably drop this. Sorry.
Yeah.
Go on.
I'm sorry. I lost my.
Yeah.
Okay, I think that's enough. Let me just do my search. I have a complete encyclopedia, my brother here, and this will, should do it. It's in Arabic, but it, there is a translation for it, no problem.
Right.
Okay, yeah, it's searching. You see, you can't read Arabic, but it says da'if.
I don't know what site that is, that's what I mean. It's written in Arabic, but I don't know what site it is.
Da'if.
He's saying it's Sahih, but this is saying Sahih. I don't know what site it's gone to.
This must be distorted, one.
Yeah, I don't know what site it's. It's some random site it's gone to. But that's you're saying it's weak. That doesn't mean it is weak. The fact is, nobody showed me it's weak. What site is that?
Show me the Arabic.
You have to
look at Arabic. This is Arabic. Show me the Arabic.
Because that site is saying Sahih. That's a Muslim site. That's a Muslim site, by the way. Sahih is saying
Sahih. It says ضعيف. ضعيف.
That one is
a no, that's a different hadith. It's saying 93.6. Why is it saying that? That doesn't say 93.6.
No, this is Sahih Bukhari.
That's not Sahih Bukhari.
It's Sahih Muslim.
That's a lie. No. You are literally
Sahih
lying.
Muslim.
That's Sahih Muslim, first of all. That's not Sahih Bukhari.
Never trust a Muslim. Never trust a Muslim.
Yeah. Never trust a Muslim.
Never trust a Muslim.
You see,
the thing is, you've shown it. That's from Sahih Muslim. Listen to me, one minute. That's from Sahih Muslim. What you're giving us, now you're attacking my character. What you're doing is you're showing us hadith that is not true. What I need you to do is show me a source that says that that is da'if, right? That's mutawatir. And in English, please. Please show me.
I will never force you. You will never be able to force me.
I'm not trying to force you.
No. But I'm trying to say, my brother, my dear brother, John. We should be on a higher level. We are trying, at the end of the day, to reach, hopefully, appeasement to God Almighty. Not appeasing me, not appeasing you, God right. Almighty. So, saying or attacking somebody, being a liar, I don't know how old you are, John, but I have my daughter, she's a neurologist, she's 37 years old.
Right.
I don't know if you're 37 yet or not, but I would have more respect.
I'm going to be honest, bro, this has nothing to do with the conversation. I'm not trying to be rude.
When you say liar, because you're an older man.
What I'm saying is you're lying because you haven't shown us that. What you've done is you've ran to a source which is supposedly in Arabic and it says 93.6. It doesn't say the exact store number. That says Sahih Muslim. You said that was Sahih Bukhari, correct?
No, Sahih Bukhari. This is the same hadith. It says the Kani Yom Al-Qiyamah.
Wait, Sahih Bukhari. Wait, Sahih Bukhari.
It doesn't say anywhere.
Show me in Arabic, Sahih Bukhari.
I'll show you. But anyway, this is
Sahih. No.
What I think you're doing is because I don't speak Arabic, you're trying to play up to the Arabic. I've known Muslims to do this. I've done this a lot of times. And what I want you to do is be honest. Show me a hadith radar in English that states that this is da'if. If you cannot, then you cannot possibly attack the
Islam. It's not my problem. You don't know Arabic, my brother.
But the problem is, I shouldn't know Arabic, first of all, to know your point. Your point should be clear. These hadiths on sunnah.com, listen to what I'm saying. These hadiths on sunnah.com, right? They were written by Muslims. They were not written by me or Christians.
Can you accept the humble recommendation from your brother? Just a humble. Please. Humble request. I'm a retired engineer. Listen.
Go on. Speak.
My dear brother, I pray to God Almighty that He guides all of us to the right path. I pray. And I pray to God Almighty He shows us the right path.
Well, I pray the real God, the actual God, the true God Yahweh, who is triune, shows us the true God.
Listen, say God Almighty.
No, I say the true God, the triune God, Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit, the Father. We're not changing the subject, bro. We're getting on to this because I know what you're trying to do. You've attacked, listen, bro, let's be honest, yeah?
Okay.
You've attacked the atonement. You've said it doesn't make sense for Jesus Christ to pay the sins of so many people. That's what you've said when you came up to me, right?
Does it make sense to you?
But the problem is, it doesn't, in your Quran, in your hadith, if you're going to have that, if you're going to have a problem with that, then you may as well leave Islam because in your hadith it says that Jews and Christians will pay for the sins of Muslims. So again, somebody else who's innocent will be paying for the sins of the guilty.
No, this is again, John. But anyway, you know,
there's no tafsir for this hadith.
You can lead the horse to water, the guy's horse to drink. What can I do?
Exactly. He's run off. All right, see you later, man. How you doing, bro? You good? That's good. Oh yeah, take back your phone, sorry. I don't know where JC's gone, he just ran off.
The guy there wanted to say that.
Oh, you want to wrap up? Okay, so basically, I was having a conversation with this older gentleman about the atonement, right? He came up to me and said, look, the atonement makes no sense, right? How can Jesus Christ pay an innocent man, pay for the sins of mankind, right? But my problem there is with him is that he has a double standard, because according to his own Sahih Hadith, it says this. Abu Masa reported, and I want Muslims to really understand this, Abu Masa reported that Allah's messenger said, when it will be the day of resurrection, Allah will deliver to every Muslim a Jew or a Christian and say, that is your rescue from hellfire. So basically, the Muslims' rescue from hellfire is Jews and Christians. This is not right. This is definitely not a good atoning factor. It makes sense in terms of Jesus Christ, because Jesus Christ is our Lord. He became our perpetual sacrifice, our redeemed lamb, right? Who redeems the whole of mankind. But with this is saying that Jews and Christians who are innocent, who Allah willed, by the way, to sin and to forget Islam, are going to pay for the sins of Jews, for the sins of Muslims. Right? At the end of the day, I think Muslims, you should really look at this when you think about attacking the atonement.